Excuse me, is this room B101? My guidance counselor told me to come here.
Are you Dr. Lucas?
Are we late?
Hey, dude, I take full responsibility. Trouser Snake got loose in their science class and had to put it back in its cage.
L-O-V-E. Love.
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 Love contains a variety of usages. Today, we're going to discuss the love one has for their significant other. The most confusing mask that love puts on. It knocks on your door and says, trick or treat. But what does love mean? What is the essence of it aside from emotion? Is there one? I love you. Raise your hands if you vomited those three words to your respective partners. Put your hands down. Love at your age. It's as confusing as Chinese algebra, and it's as natural as a bowel movement. Myths of love are literary attempts at expressing a basic truth or enforcing a moral. It provides something tangible, something you don't need a yearbook or a log to remember, because it's relative and it's real. Myth number one. True love lasts forever. One could wish. Some blokes maintain this myth in an interesting way. If their love disintegrates, they conclude that it was never genuine to begin with. It was a love fashioned merely from infatuation or comfortable compatibility.
Hey, Sean.
Hey, what's up? What are you doing here? I thought you had to work.
I do. I mean, I did. I'm just going in an hour late, that's all. How was the game?
We lost.
Sorry.
It's all right. We overachieved to begin with, so I guess it was all bittersweet.
Always the optimist.
You can't let the small shit get you down. It just piles up. Then where are you?
Trapped under a mountain of shit?
Exactly.
Do you want to go inside?
Yeah, I need to hit the shower.
You stink. Where's your mom?
Is that the neighbors?
And your dad?
He's shopping.
For what?
My graduation present, hopefully. Did you come over here for sex?
Sean, no.
You came over here for an afternoon pre-work booty call.
No, I didn't.
Yeah, you did. Well.
I just had to kill some time before work, that's all.
Yeah, and you wanted to kill it with sex.
Can't we just talk?
All right. Try and mask it. But I know the truth. I know what's going to happen in about 10 minutes. You and me.
You're very confident, aren't you? Forgive me for deflating your balloon, but we will not be having sex today.
All right. So what's up? What does bring you into my bedroom today?
Well, actually, I
can you give me a pair of jeans, please? On the side of the bed.
These are filthy. Don't you do wash?
I do wash. Just not recently.
Has this been going on the whole time we've been dating?
Yeah, possibly. Probably.
And why haven't I noticed?
I'll show you why you haven't noticed. All you gotta do is just shake out the dirt, the odor, and all the hidden little nasties. Top it off, squirt a cologne. I like dry or fresh.
Ooh, what's this?
What's what?
Piece of paper?
I don't know. Probably a receipt.
Dear Mandy, can you believe graduation is but a few days away?
Wait. Here, give me that.
Our lives are forever changed because of each other. Not only that, but our lives are forever connected for many reasons. 3 years together and 3 years full of love.
You're not lying. I dare you.
Why did you do this? I know all this stuff.
That's right, you do. So give it to me.
Blah, blah, blah.
Why'd you have to do that?
Do what? You wrote it for me.
But I haven't given it to you yet.
What's the difference?
Big difference. Oh, Jesus.
Oh, there's a second side. So in having told you all the places my emotions
right,
have visited...
I'm coming down.
While I've been with you,
back,
I feel it's the best thing for the both of us.
Just give me a letter back, please.
You want to break up? That wasn't what I was expecting.
Yeah, I know. I'm sorry.
Okay.
The letter, right? I know, it's stupid. It's junior high style. It's a coward's way out, but I wasn't actually going to give you the letter. I just had to blueprint my feelings.
Okay, Sean.
And I don't know how I would ever say those things to you. God, I hate this. I really hate this. You know, I wasn't supposed to be like this. I really thought I can do it. You know, get us back to the way we were, but ever since New Year's, we've just been drifting further and further.
Okay.
You can be mad, but, you know, you have to agree with me on this. We aren't what we once were, and patching things up and rebuilding are both far gone.
I said okay.
Will you just listen to me? You know, I want to say everything in this letter. I want to explain it to you. I want you to understand where I'm coming from. Full closure, I owe that to you.
That's why I came over here.
It was?
Yeah.
Wow. Why?
You already said why. We need to hang them up. Retire. The last thing I want is for us to be sitting in our dorms, on the phone, sending cards, messaging. Meanwhile, college passes us by. If we're meant to be, we'll be. I love you, Sean. But there's life after high school, and I don't think we would survive as is.
There's a lot out there we know nothing about.
But we know what we had, and we know what we will be.
We just can't be together.
Are you asking me?
No.
This summer would have been torture on us.
Yeah.
What is it?
This was too easy. Is that bad?
No. Were you expecting a fight? A knockdown, drag-out brawl, complete with harsh sentiments and tears.
A little bit.
So did I. Things rarely happen according to plan. Growing up sucks. I'll miss you, Sean.
Myth number two! Love is a purely positive experience. Yeah, right. Society's idealized views of love often creates the illusion that it's a purely enjoyable experience. In reality, pain, anger, and ambivalent feelings are common in love relationships. It's unrealistic to expect love to be entirely pleasant. The intense nature of love means that love is capable of taking you to emotional peaks in either direction.
Sean, I have to tell you something.
Fire away.
I'm not happy.
Okay, with what?
Us.
What do you mean? What? Man, are you gonna say something here, please? Hello, ring ring, hello?
Sean, I'm not happy.
Say what you wanna say. Say what you wanna say.
There's something that I...
Something you wanna do? Something you wanna say? Something you wanna say to me? Yeah? You want surgery on your 11th toe. You failed gym. Your breasts are uneven. No, this isn't working. So, all right, you wanna go on vacation? You wanna go to community college? You don't like me anymore? You want me to get a haircut? You wanna break up? All right, say it.
Yeah.
You don't sound convinced. That's not what you really want to do, no? And you know that.
I do. I think we should.
I couldn't hear you. Could you just emote a little bit for me?
I do. I think we should.
Why?
I already told you why.
Because we had a few arguments? Because we stepped on a rough patch? So what? Couples do that. They move on. They get stronger. Don't give up.
I'm not happy.
I thought what you told me last week...
I know what I said.
Do you? Because I want to remind you. I think it's important. You said that you think you're falling in love with me. And now?
And now I don't feel the same way as I did last week. I'm not happy.
Stop saying that. That is bullshit. This is bullshit, all right? This is the... You're being very selfish.
I'm selfish?
Yeah.
I'm selfish.
Yes. You're being selfish.
I'm selfish.
Yes, you are. This is so ridiculously not fair.
I think it's for the best.
All right, but why?
I just don't feel the same way about you anymore.
All right, but last night...
What about it?
You don't remember?
No, I remember. What about it?
Are you joking? After what we did, you now feel this way. After what we did, you now feel the need to, dare I say, end it. Over what? Nothing.
I need to do this. For me.
Gosh, you're so selfish.
You're being selfish too.
No, I'm not. I'm trying to be rational and logical.
Then why can't you just break up? Why can't you just accept this?
I really like you.
Is that it?
It's not it. Mandy, I want you. You're smart, you're beautiful, you have this great laugh that always puts me in a good mood. I dig everything about you. I think we could be something really, really good together. Don't do this.
You don't want me to do this because it means only one thing.
Oh, please, it means a whole shitload to me.
No. It just means that now you're going to be alone. I mean nothing more to you than your dog. You just want someone to lick your face and hump your leg. It doesn't matter who it is. You don't really care about me.
How could you belittle my feelings like that? Why won't you just listen to me when I'm telling you that I want you? We had sex last night.
Barely. I was there.
Are you trying to hurt me?
Sean, no. Things are just gonna get worse if we stay together. I thought last night was going to help. But I need to do this for me.
Why? You're telling me straight up, flat out, that I meant nothing to you.
Sean, I care about you. I just can't be your girlfriend.
Is it someone else?
That's not the point.
Was I not any good? Gina, it was my first time.
You were fine.
Ow. Fuck, what the hell?
Look, I'm sorry. This isn't easy for me either.
Yeah, well, it sure looks easy.
Come on. This is one of the hardest things I've ever had to do. And I had Miss Berman for Spanish class 2 years in a row.
Don't make jokes. It just undermines your sincerity.
I still want to be friends.
Don't do this. Please, don't do this. Mandy, I'm begging you. Stop.
I think it's for the best.
But why? You're not being fair.
I'm sorry.
You don't want to do this.
I need to do this for me.
You owe us. You owe us a second chance. You owe us an opportunity to make this right again.
It's not gonna work.
Yes, it will. Look, I know now how much I need you. I'm sitting here so fucking scared that when you leave, we won't be what we were last night. I'm so scared.
I'm sorry.
I don't want to lose you yet. We have so much to do. Just give me another chance and I won't fuck it up.
How do you know that?
I know how I feel right now, on the verge of losing you. And I don't ever want to feel this way again. I will try harder. To be whatever it is that you need me to be for you. I'll try anything. I'll try everything. Just this can't be the end.
I think it is.
But why? You're not being fair.
I'm not happy.
Bullshit. This is all bullshit. What'd you do? Read Breaking Up for Dummies and memorize every cliche line? I'm not happy. For the best. Whatever. Just tell me what you really feel. Tell me your true feelings. Where are they? Please, just express them to me now. Please.
Not with you. Not anymore. I'm sorry. We had a good run, Sean. You won't be alone for long. Trust me.
I don't want to be without you.
That'll change.
I don't want it to.
There's nothing I can do.
So this is it.
Goodbye.
What? No, where are you going? Can't leave like this.
I have nothing more to say to you.
Wait.
Sean, what do you want from me?
I want you. I want you to trust me. I want you to let me fix whatever's wrong. I want you.
I'm sorry for everything. But at the top of my list, I'm sorry I had sex with you last night. I regret thinking that it would change our relationship. Sex usually changes everything. When I left your house last night, I deconstructed all my feelings into a tiny little ball and walked away with the fact that having sex with you changed nothing.
But what needs to be changed? What needs to be changed? Tell me, just what is it that needs to be changed?
Sorry this turned out this way. It was not my intention.
Just give me one thing specifically I did to deserve this bomb being set off inside of my chest. Please, just give me one thing.
I'm...
You're what?
Not fucking happy!
But I love you.
Fucking loser.
And finally,
what's up, Doc?
The third myth. When you fall in love, you'll know it. Absolutely bloody not. People often spend a great deal of time agonizing over whether they're really in love or only experiencing infatuation. Numerous blokes have difficulty distinguishing lust from love. Confusion about a romantic relationship is not the least bit unusual, and it does not mean that you aren't really in love.
Hey, honey.
Shit. What the hell are you doing here? Hi.
What a warm reception. Thank you.
I'm sorry, but you scared me. What's up? What are you doing here?
To see you, silly.
I'm on my way out. Can we just get together later?
Where are you going?
3 hours? I'm going...
Where are you going?
What?
Where are you going?
Nowhere. I just go on a Blockbuster, get a video game or something. Something to eat. A donut maybe.
Can I come with?
Why?
Why not? I'm your girlfriend. Remember, we're supposed to do everything together? Or at least we used to, anyway.
What? What does that mean? We just relax. We'll get together later.
Who's that?
Who's what?
Aren't you going to answer it?
No. It's in the bag.
Shopping at Victoria's Secret. Pick something up nice. Take up
something so revealing and tight that you could be picking it out of your ass.
You have such a way with words. Can we go inside?
All right.
Yeah.
Wait, Mandy, where are you going? Go upstairs, my room. I just washed my sheets. Mandy. What are you doing? Let's go upstairs.
Where are your mom and dad this afternoon?
They're at the retirement home till 6. Mom's teaching yoga and dad's rehearsing.
Rehearsing for what?
I thought I told you.
Nope, haven't told me.
They're performing Midsummer Night's Dream, set at the background of a garage sale in October.
Are you serious?
Yeah. 25-cent hammer, 10-cent dinnerware, geriatric magic and merriment, Shakespeare style. Whole town will be there.
Can't wait to see it.
I can't wait to see what you got in that bag.
You want to see what's in this here bag?
I want to see you and what's in that bag.
So do I.
Well, all right, let's hop to it. Let's get that shit on.
No.
Yes.
I want to see you in what's in this here bag.
What?
Well, I'm just trying to keep this relationship fresh and exciting. I wouldn't want things to go stale, you know? After a while, you don't want the same boring plain slice of pizza offered night after night. So, this, maybe, we are alone. Come on, let's entertain.
Sure, what the hell, I'll do it. Let's go upstairs.
Let's do it here.
Let's do it what?
Right here on this couch.
My parents will be home soon. Let's not do it here. Let's go upstairs.
It's 4:30. We have over an hour. That'll give us more than enough time.
Now, what's that supposed to mean?
I'm not implying anything.
I think you were. That's not cool, all right? That topic is very sensitive to me and what I represent. I am not a two-hump chump, all right?
Just put it on.
This is gonna be weird. It's so worth it.
Give me your pants.
What?
Your pants. Toss them out, big boy.
Why?
Just do it. I need a manager.
Catch.
Gracias.
De nada.
Stupid slut.
Hey, so what are we gonna do here? I mean, how's the show gonna play out?
You'll see. I won't disappoint my man. Cross my heart. Shit, it's Mandy.
Who is that?
You know, third period, phys ed. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah, who is... Can I...
Oh, Shannon! Yeah, are you fucking my boyfriend, Sean? Yeah, my boyfriend, Sean. Are you fucking him? Yeah. Okay, thank you.
Yeah, just... Hi. Can I... Let me explain something?
Explain what?
Explain what? What'd she tell you?
Who?
Who? The girl on the fucking phone.
Oh, Shannon.
Yes, Shannon.
Put your fucking pants on, dick.
Come on now.
So how long have you and the pigeon-toed, titless head cheerleader been screwing?
All right, look. I'm sorry.
Sorry? For what?
I have no idea what is going on here.
How's your teddy feeling?
It's tight.
Good.
Why is that good? Why can't we just go upstairs?
It is, to my understanding, that last night between the hours of 9 p.m. and 2 a.m., you were at Eric's house on Sherwood Drive, correct?
I was.
I'm sorry, what?
I did. I was there.
Mm-hmm. And there was a good amount of people there. Some might even call it a party. Was it not?
It was. It was a party.
And I was home alone under the impression that you were homesick with a case of food poisoning brought on by a slice of pizza courtesy of Seaside Park Boardwalk.
I was.
What?
I mean, you were. You were.
And while I was home alone, you were at Eric's house drinking, partying, and having a good whatever. Then you got into Shannon's dirty little panties, didn't you?
Mandy, look. I'm sorry. I am really sorry.
You're not sorry. You just got caught.
I'm confessing. I'm coming clean. I'm apologizing.
Bullshit. You were never going to tell me. You were going to see her today, weren't you? You were going to see her today, weren't you?
No.
Liar.
I was going to Blockbuster to get a video game. Xbox. Shit's awesome.
Were you going to break up with me?
No. Mandy, no. I really like you.
I like you too, Sean. You're the only guy I've ever been with, and I probably was falling in love with you. I would have done anything. Anything.
What do you want me to do?
Make it right.
Okay, you got it. How do I make this right?
I want you to call Shannon and tell her it's over.
It was just a one-time thing.
Call her, tell her it's over, that you realize how much I mean to you and you wouldn't want to jeopardize our relationship. You love me.
That's not going to work.
I'm paraphrasing. Use your own words and mean it.
I mean, she knows you know this changes the whole situation.
No, she doesn't. I never called her. I told you, I already knew. You just gave me confirmation. Now you? Call her. Call her.
Fine. Hey, babe. How you doing? Hi, Shay. Listen, I can't come over today. Something's come up. No, I'm all right. I'm fine. Everything's good. Just I'll explain it all to you later. A little later tonight.
Focus.
Listen, honestly, I gotta call it off. Our whole situation is just not working for me. Yeah, it was fun, but I just... The thing about it is, I love somebody else. I mean, really. I love Mandy. Hello? What, you just...
She'll get over it. Girl gets around like a pinwheel. She'll look down on anyone who knows her name.
Yeah, sure.
Jerk.
Well, I'll tell you, I feel a lot better.
Me too.
This is good. This whole situation helped us. We'll rebound.
Yeah.
So seriously, let's go upstairs. This thong is really starting to get me excited now.
Whatever this is. Was this nylon or silk or something? But all right, you're going upstairs, right?
Sweet.
Goodbye, Sean. I'll see you around.
What, you're leaving? That's not supposed to happen.
Neither are we.
Hey, Manny. Hang on. I've changed. We can make this work, because I love you. All right, that's what I'm talking about. Come on, let's go upstairs, let's get naked, let's have some fun. Oh, I'm glad I never gave you an orgasm. What a bitch. Hey, Shay, Sean, how are you? Look, I was joking. Who's Mandy? I don't know no Mandy. Come on over. All right, then I'll come over. Shut up on me. Fuck. change your mind. Don't worry, this isn't yours. So what's for dinner?
Anything for a little bit of crumpet, eh? You like wearing the girl's clothes, don't you, boy? You like the silk feeling on your bits and pieces, your kibbles and bits. You look dead sexy. Oh, it's almost happy hour. There's a pint of Guinness somewhere with Dr. Lucas's name on it. Love is an emotion. It's universal. It's venerable. The six of you will experience a candy assortment of love in your lifetime, each having their own special meaning. But the most important ingredient mixed in, the bulk of the said emotion, is ownership. Own that love like you own your own fist. Tight, powerful, with conviction, ready to strike a blow. Oh, class dismissed.
So afraid that we will have to part. Each night I ask the stars up above, why must I be a teenager in love? One day I feel so happy, next day I feel so sad. I guess I'll have to be a teenager in love. I cried a tear for nobody but you. I'll be a lonely one if you should say we're through. Well, if you wanna make me cry, that won't be so hard to do. If and you should say goodbye, must I be a teenager in love? I cried a tear for nobody but you. I'll be a lonely one if you should say we're through. Well, if you wanna make me cry, that won't be so hard to do. And if you say goodbye, must I be a teenager in love?